Hi, I'm Jenny Barnett Rohrs, your host. I like to create my own style statement, and you can too with today's projects. We're gonna start off with this personalized bracelet. We're gonna make it out of polymer clay and loom bands, so let me show you what you need. You're going to need a couple of different colors of polymer clay, and I like red and white, but you can pick your school colors or your favorite colors. You're going to need some mini cookie cutters. I like to use ovals, some loom bands, some acrylic paint, and a Q-tip to apply it, a rolling pin, and I like one of these little loom tools because it's really super handy. You also may want to have some cling wrap on hand and work on a covered surface. So we're going to start off with conditioning the polymer clay. You do this for two reasons. First of all, when you work it in your hands, it warms it up and makes it easier to work with, and it also remixes the ingredients, which is really important so that it bakes well. Now, we're going to start off by taking our bit of clay and we're going to roll it out using a pin, or if you have a pasta machine, you can do that too. And you're going to make, I'd say about a nickel's width piece. And then we're going to take a little piece of cling wrap and put it over our clay, like so. And then use the largest oval cookie cutter to create an oval shape, like this. Ta-da! And it's all done. Now, we're gonna do the same process using our white polymer clay, but this time we're going to use the next size smaller. It's gonna be kind of a stacked look, like this. And when you take off that cling wrap, it really makes the edges really cute and round. So now I'm just gonna stack one on top of the other, and pick it up and just use my fingers to kind of smooth off the edges and kind of press it together to make sure that the clay is adhering. You want to make sure there aren't any bubbles between the layers. Okay, now let's have a little bit of fun. We are going to create a rope around the edge, and I'm going to take a little bit of scrap clay, just a little bit of red and a little bit of white, and we're going to create like a peppermint twist by taking these two pieces, rolling them into a snake, like so, and just kind of drawing it out. Now the technique really is to kind of make one hand go forward a little more and one hand go back a little more, and then kind of even it up and stretch. And you see how I'm kind of just rolling and stretching and rolling and stretching to create kind of a peppermint stripe. Now we're gonna take this piece and just tap it around the outside edge, like so. And if we need to, we can fill in a little bit. You can add a little more. You can even create a little swirl at the top where the two ends join together, which is kind of what I'm doing right here. Just decorate it the way you like, but just make sure you tap it all together so that the pieces stick to each other. Now, I'm going to go ahead and pick this up because the next part is the personalized part of the personalized ID bracelet, and we're going to impress our names in. Now I'm using these little teeny weeny rubber stamps. If you have them, use them. You could also use those alphabet noodles, but what I'm gonna do is just spell my nephew's name right inside. If you have a long name, you might wanna just use the monogram, which would be your first initial, your middle initial, and your last initial. So now what we're gonna do is take this piece and give it some texture by using this little hooky tool. The first thing I'm gonna do is just go around the outside and add some little dots and lines. I can go ahead and make two holes on either side. This is where we're gonna attach our band, so it's kind of important that you do that before you bake it. And then you can also just use the end and make little polka dots, just like this. You can kind of get creative and add as much or as little texture as you want, but when you've got it the way you like it, just bend it slightly like this and put it on a piece of paper and bake it according to the manufacturer's directions. And you're gonna want some adult help with this, but put it in the oven, bake it, and let it cool in there so you don't burn your fingers. When it comes out, it's gonna look something like this. And then, because those letters don't stand out really well, we're gonna add a little bit of black paint. And all you have to do is smudge a little on top so it gets into the holes, and then use a baby wipe or a paper towel and just kind of dab it off. And if you rub, you see that actually it stays into the grooves, which is kind of nice. And if you want it to be a little lighter, add a little bit of water and then wipe it away. Now, the last thing is to let this dry so that you can start making the band. And I have one kind of started here, but we're gonna use this loom tool again. It's nice and handy for this. And what we're gonna do is take one, take a band, fold it in half, and poke it through one of those holes that you made, just like this. Then you're going to bring your tool through both, grab another rubber band loom, and thread it through the two loops that you made to begin with. And I kind of go like this. Let's see, make sure they're not twisted, because if they twist, then you're not gonna be able to get them through, which is what I just did. I'll try that again. There we go. And bring it through, and then hold it, and add another one. And you're gonna go ahead and finish this process and put one of those little C clamps on the end and do the other side so that you have enough looms to go all the way around your wrist. I'm gonna finish this one off by pulling it through like so and then connecting it together. And of course you can use any size that works for you so that it goes on your bracelet and any color that you like.